Hello, and welcome to our lesson on precision DACs. In this video, we will discuss how a DAC can be calibrated to help eliminate some inherent errors. Before we talk about what we can calibrate, let's first look at what errors we cannot calibrate. The first is full-scale error because it is a localized endpoint error that doesn't affect the entire transfer function. For the same reason, zero-scale error cannot be calibrated. We likewise cannot calibrate for INL because it is the inherent variation that changes from device to device. If you wanted to measure each individual code, you could create a lookup table to calibrate it digitally, but that is a very impractical and costly solution. However, we can calibrate for offset error and gain error, which are two out of the three errors that affect a DAC's precision. Recall that the standard method for expressing DC error in a DAC is by calculating the TUE, total unadjusted error. Let's see how calibration can positively affect our TUE. Calibration is done in the linear region of the DAC, which is where the offset and gain error are measured. The datasheet specifies the codes at which these measurements are taken. The easiest way to do the calibration is by using a two-point approach, taking points on either end of the linear region. The offset calibration code is the difference in the measured and ideal Y values at the low code. The gain calibration ratio is calculated from the slope of the measured line. Finally, you can put these calculations into the new code equation to get the adjusted code value you should use. Programming this routine into your digital controller will often drastically decrease your system TUE. Just remember that using this method could address a code that is out of range of your controller, like trying to address code hex 9 on a 3-bit DAC. Make sure your programming scheme takes this into account. For an example, let's take the DAC 8562. Uncalibrated, the DAC 8562 provides a TUE of 15 LSBs, but a calibrated TUE of only 4 LSBs. To illustrate, let's look at the numbers. Listed here are the INL, offset, and gain errors for the DAC 8562 found in the datasheet. Note that we needed to convert the specs units into LSBs if it wasn't already specified that way. Using the max values from the datasheet and plugging them into the TUE equation, the DAC 8562 has plus or minus 112 LSBs of total unadjusted error. Using the typical values from the datasheet, the error drops to plus or minus 15 LSBs. Let's see what happens after we calibrate. Calibrating correctly will effectively eliminate the offset and gain error terms of the TUE equation, leaving only INL to affect the TUE calculation. Here we see that by calibrating, we have reduced the TUE to plus or minus 4 LSBs with a maximum of plus or minus 12. Keep in mind that this method may introduce about half of an LSB of offset error because of rounding in the adjusted code calculations. That said, the gains from calibrating are generally well worth the cost based on the TUE reduction shown here. Thank you for watching this video on calibration of precision DACs. Please watch our other videos on precision DACs or go to ti.com/precisiondac to learn more.